Sean Benoit, who is leading by more than a minute and a half. The big crowd lining Exposition Boulevard. That is a west-to-east route she is running right now. It's a road that parallels the Santa Monica Freeway. Before they built that freeway, oh, about 15, 20 years ago, it used to be the way to get from the west side
miles,
of town to the Coliseum. So she is traveling
miles.
A well-traveled route. You heard the spotter call out 23 miles, so 3.25 miles to go. Now, we told you there are other events taking place in the Los Angeles Coliseum, other track events. No finals. There are preliminary heats and field preliminaries taking place there, and there's a crowd of, we understand, 50 to 60,000 at the Coliseum, and it will be deafening when Joan Benoit gets there. There is Greta Weitz, and she, too, with the adulation from the large crowd that has gathered along just about every step of the way.
Well, Al, Greta Weitz has almost become an American heroine, too. I mean, she established herself as a marathoner in this country long ago when she said, I'm still a 1,500-meter runner. She was breaking the world record in the New York City Marathon and showing women everywhere how incredible women could perform. So she's become very popular, well-known in America. And, in fact, she and her husband, Jack, really like living here a lot because she's become so well-known in Norway that living a private life is kind of difficult for them.
So the universal sign for water, instead of saying water in English, it simply said H2O, and everybody knows what that is. The perspective is, you look up ahead, you can see as you look over the shoulder of Greta Weitz that you cannot even see Joan Benoit up ahead, and that has to be very dispiriting for her.
Al, she's put a wet sponge right on the back of her neck. A lot of runners have a lot of problem with the heat right on the back of the neck because it's very debilitating. You know, the old French Foreign Legion guys used to wear those white kerchiefs hanging down from their hats, and a lot of the New Zealand and Australian runners have always worn kerchiefs to cover that part of the back of their neck. Greta has tied up her hair to keep cool in this race as possible, but I think she's trying to keep the sun off.
Well, let's get a weather report. We haven't checked in with Bill Rogers on that for several minutes. It looks like it's a little brighter. And what about the heat right now, Bill?
The heat doesn't seem that intense. Joan is running under these showers that are set up along the side of the road. She's taking sponges, taking her water. She looks strong. Every once in a while, she makes a face or something. But I think she's very much under control. And again, I think she's going to handle the distance to the stadium just like this. And she looks fine.
She does, very similar, as we say, to that race she ran in the Olympic trials 11, 12 weeks ago. 5:36, she is just absolutely machine-like now. 5:36, that last mile, and still over a minute and a half lead. And now we understand Weitz has picked up the pace a bit, and Weitz has picked up on that last lap about 10 seconds from roughly 1:40 to a minute and a half. So she's still a minute and a half back with, we would guess right now, less than 3 miles to go.
Well, Joni has been running some of her slower miles. She's now down around 5:36, but she has so much of a cushion now with 3 miles left to go. It's going to be very hard for Greta to catch her. Joni would almost have to catch some cramps, really drop off to close to 6-minute mile pace for her to lose this lead. It would have to be a sudden drop. And as Bill said, she's grimacing a little, but she is in no grave danger. Kind of tough for Greta. She's used to running the New York Marathon and being the most famous and cheered for woman in the race, being told where she is. No one is yelling to her, you know, you're 300 yards behind. And here is the race for the bronze medal. Rosa Moda must have hung in there, gone through a bad patch, gathered herself and come back up. She has just that 1 yard lead now on Christensen. And of course, Christensen would love to join Greta and be the second and third place medalist.
You know, Marty, nobody thought Joni was really going to do this. I mean, who was ever going to take out and just bust open the race like this? Well, Joni has done it. I know the Norwegians really didn't believe she was going to do it, even for all the talk of her capability. And now the tactical race that Greta has planned has really come back to haunt her a little bit. She's going to have her work cut out for ever getting close to her.
Well, there, as we dissolve, isn't that something? And that's where it all ends. She will come in through the tunnel on the left-hand portion of your screen. Come right in off Menlo Avenue through that tunnel. Then what happens is they set up cones. In lane five, she will run around the track, will run down to the finish line. That's where, just about that spot is where Carl Lewis started the 100 last night, and run outside of those cones, cross the finish line, and then go around one time. So 400 meters remaining, and you can well imagine what it's going to be like in the Coliseum when Joan Benoit arrives there, and that will be taking place in a very short period of time.
You know, Al, we had said that the Americans are certainly winning their share of gold medals in this Olympic Games. The marathon, the women's marathon, is probably the one race that is totally unaffected by the Soviet boycott. Raisa Smetkova got a third place in the World Championships last year in Helsinki, but that wasn't a very, very tough field. So the Soviets really didn't have much of a chance here anyway. And besides, when the marathon was voted in for the Olympic Games for women, the Soviets were the ones who voted against it.
Joan Benoit and Greta Weiss running 1-2 as the marathon winds down.
These women have a dream to be the first in the first Olympic women's marathon. This event has been Avon's dream, and the Avon International Marathons gave women the opportunity they needed to prove themselves to the world and to the Olympic Committee. For them, the dream is about to become a reality. For Avon, it already has.
Promises come shining through.
We're with you.
The people of ABC News, uniquely qualified to bring you the world.
The partnership of Auguste Bartholdi, the sculptor, and Gustav Eiffel, the engineer, would produce an artistic achievement which would become the symbol of liberty. With them went the hopes and dreams of people around the world. The best way to achieve your dream is to have a partner who shares it. Republic Bank. Together we make it happen.
I'm an auto parts specialist. I know parts. I know accessories and tools. This patch means I'm a qualified counterman at your CarQuest Auto Parts store.
Keep out from under expensive engine repairs. Get a Fram oil filter. Regular oil changes and a new Fram oil filter can help keep your engine running like new. Fram oil filters at CarQuest.
I can help.
The man behind the patch at CarQuest, the right place to buy auto parts.
We don't waste the water. The water won't run out.
The Games of the 23rd Olympiad. Brought to you by Canon, proud to be the world's leader in 35mm photography and the official camera of the 1984 Olympics. Local McDonald's restaurants who joined together to build the Olympic Swim Stadium. Permaflex, the new state-of-the-art 30-day lenses. Permaflex take in plenty of oxygen and are incredibly comfortable from the makers of Permalex. And Avon, proud supporters of the Women's Olympic Marathon. Congratulations to all the Olympic athletes from Avon.
Joan Benoit with a little bit more than 2 miles to go as she approaches the 24-mile mark of the women's marathon. She is moving down Exposition Boulevard, heading toward the Coliseum, where they have a large crowd that has gathered. And Joan Benoit said, you heard 24 and a half. And the split time read out by the spotter. And there is the Coliseum. You can see how many people are in the Coliseum. Other track events taking place. And we're moving back, and Joan Benoit, 126 out in front of Greta Weiss. She heads toward the finish line.
Has just left it too late. We won't know until it's over whether Greta just believed in her heart that Joan Benoit would have to come back to her, or whether Greta was being conservative because of the heat, whether she felt she was pushing it as hard as she could in the early stages. But now she is working, but it's going to be too late. Joan Benoit has built up too much of a cushion. Joan is slowing down, but it's not going to be enough at this point. The people in the stadium are watching this on the big screen. Joni can probably hear the cheers of the crowd. and this tremendous self-control when she crosses the finish line. You know, it's not that she's an unemotional person. It's just that she can control her emotions and focus so well.
All right, Bill Rogers is right there in the lead vehicle in front of Joan Benoit. What do you see right now, Bill?
Joni looks a little tired. There's no question about it. She's come almost 25 miles. There's been bright sun the last five or six miles. The only way she's been able to counteract that is she's wearing a hat and she's been ducking under these showers, taking water drinks. She looks totally under control still. She's slowed down a little. I can see her body movement doesn't have quite the snap, but she looks fine. I would say the temperature is in the 70s somewhere. There's a bright sun. It's kind of hazy. But Joan looks under control. I see no signs of muscle cramping in her legs, arms, anything. I think Joan has this well under control. No question about it.
It appears that, look at that crowd. I mean, it's just incredible. And that's all she will be hearing. And then will be that huge din. And I guess you just have to try to imagine it yourself. She'll be coming through that relatively dark tunnel and then into the bright sunlight of the Coliseum. And as the vista opens up, will be maybe 70,000 people in this gigantic roar, obviously.
Interesting this behind perspective of Greta. She is really, really working. But Marty, I don't know what you think. I think she looks a little tired than I've ever seen her. She has been really pushing here to try to make up time, but it's sort of useless.
Well, she's waving now. She's, you know, saying it's all over. Maybe her husband Jack was near this point and has told her what the difference is, and now she's just maintaining. You know, the interesting thing will be to see when Joni comes in. She'll have about 500 meters to go. She would have to have some reaction to that crowd.
It's interesting that this is going to be Greta's first loss, if you can consider a silver medal a loss, in any of her marathons. All eight that she has finished, she has won a lot of those with world records. And earlier we said this doing a tactical race has come back
miles,
to haunt her. I guess she really thought that the tactical race would have won it.
First time ever for the Olympic Women's Marathon. The day has belonged to Joan Benoit.
Again, my one.
Je te reverrai dans tous ces charmants jours d'été, dans tout ce qui est si léger, si gai. Je t'imaginerai toujours ainsi.
Memories don't have to be a thing of the past. Tomorrow, you can be anywhere.
Et je te reverrai.
This is a highly sophisticated business computer. And to use it, all you have to do is learn this. This is Macintosh from Apple, also a highly sophisticated business computer, and to use it, all you have to do